On Bishop Barra's YouTube channel, you will find exclusive content to uplift your faith. The Word of Faith with Bishop Macedo. Live meetings from Bishop Barra Fonseca. Testimonies, thoughtful advice, prayers, and much more. Do you like it? Then subscribe today and share the videos on your social network. You are listening now to A Word of Faith with Bishop Macedo.
Hello, my dear listeners. May God bless you abundantly, you who believe. Because those who believe, they are standing. Those who don't believe, they are falling. And they are weak. But do not be desperate. Do not be saddened, you who are fallen, you who are in doubts, or with anxiety, or suffering with depression, or with a life with no taste. Do not be sad. You have fallen, but the Word of God that does not return void can give you life right now. Pay attention to this word, to these scriptures that are holy, that speaks about the faith that raises the fallen, the faith that makes the fallen to be able to reach a new life, to transform their lives, the faith in which is the power of God to those who believe. It is the power of God to those who believe, and that lift up those who are fallen and makes them to stand because of the power and the strength and the energy that is the faith, the living faith upon the living God, an intelligent faith based upon God's Word. So, you can read with me. It says, thus also faith by itself, if it does not have works, is dead. For as the body without the spirit is dead, so faith without works is dead also. My dear listener, pay attention, please. You say that you have faith and that you believe in God. You have perhaps your religion. You have your philosophy of life. And you say you believe in God, and I believe that you do believe in God. But this belief that you claim to have in God, it has not been executed. And you just say that you believe because you learned to say it because of your parents that taught you about God. So then you claim you believe in God. And throughout your entire life, you have been believing in God. And that is beautiful, beautiful to hear. But this belief without, this belief without actions by itself, it has no sense and no value whatsoever. Because the Bible says that even the demons believe and tremble, but they are still demons, and they will never change. But your life can change and will change. It will change from the moment that you learn how to execute this faith that is already inside of you. Once you are able to maneuver this faith, once you are able to exercise this faith that is within you, this faith will lift you up. Because faith, my dear listener, it is the power of God to save or for the salvation of those who believe in his words. Faith, it is the power of God in order for the salvation. In order for the salvation. The salvation, not only the eternal salvation, or for eternity alone, but also the salvation as well. You can become saved right now in this moment from this life of hell that you have been dealing with. And of course, faith is an action. It is an expression. It is the power that makes us to act. Faith is the power that makes us to act and take actions. Act and take actions. And that is the reason why the Apostle James says, faith without works is dead. And that is what you have been seeing in your life and many people around you as well. And the person may say, but Bishop, I belong to a church. I am from the church A, B, or C. I am part or belong to a church. But even though I have lived a life that is, how they say, a life that has no clue, a life with no meaning, tasteless, with no salt. And why? If I am a person who is religious, I am a person that is good, a person that does no evil to no one, that has nothing to do with faith. Faith has nothing to do with charity. Faith has nothing to do with good works. Faith has nothing to do with everything or anything that we do in this world, unless when this faith is exercised and acted according to the Word of God only. When you learn to use your faith, your life will never be the same, and you are going to be able to stand, because faith, dear listener, is action. And we have many examples in the Bible about the actions of faith. Many people say, but Bishop, I have a religion, I go to church, I praise God. But you praise God, but that is where the great problem lies. Why? Because at the same time that at the church they are singing a song of worship or praise, and they raise their hands and sing hallelujah, at the same time that they give honor or adore God, or they use their faith to glorify someone that they don't even see. On the other hand, whenever they leave the church, their life is a total failure. And I know that all those who have faith, they go through tribulations. Yes, we go through tribulations in life. But the tribulation is not every day, or every year, or a whole year. No, of course not. We go through tribulations, but there is a relief. There is the victory in the end that makes the tribulation to even be a blessing. But it's not the case of many people out there that say to have faith in God, that they worship God with their mouths and their lips, but they live a mediocre life, a life completely in disgrace. Because these people have faith to glorify God, to sing glory. And this is very easy to do. This is the kind of faith, this is the kind of faith that pleases the devil. Bishop, you are telling me that this kind of faith to adore God, to glorify Him, pleases the devil? Yes. Yes, you know why? Because people think like this. Well, I am pleasing God because I'm praising Jesus. I'm worshiping and I'm raising my hands up to heaven. I pray to God. But when these same people that worship God and they leave their congregation, they leave their church, they go about solving their problems, and that faith that you just worshiped with, that you just glorified God with, doesn't solve your problem. And how come? Are you following what I'm saying? I will repeat again. How many times I would go to the church, for instance, before I converted to Christ, I would go to church for a whole year, and I would sing praises and worship. I would adore lifting my hands up to heaven, and I would do my religious obligations. But once I left the church, all my actions, they were completely opposite to everything that I did inside the church. And consequently, the problems, they would still remain. They remained in my life. So, my dear listener, do you think that God, in His great glory and mercy, has given us the Holy Spirit just for us to glorify Him? Do you think that the Holy Spirit only comes just for you to lift your hands up to heaven and glorify God? Once or twice in a week or whenever you come to church, that's it? Is that the reason of the Spirit of God or the Holy Spirit? Of course not. No way. No way. Because the person, they become illuded, thinking, no, I came to church and I glorified God. I pleased God with my worship and my adoration. I did what I had to do. I sang. I even felt the joy, the greatness of God. But is it possible that my life will not change after this night of praise? And then when they return, when they come back home, the problems are still there. Same problem. Same battles. And what about your praise early on in that day? Did it count? Honestly, answer yourself. A religious faith makes people to take or to have a good feeling when they are inside the church. But once they leave the church, then everything changes, because that faith that caused a good sensation at the church did not resolve and does not resolve the problem. They still are sad, they are still depressed, they are still dealing with anxiety, they are still running after the wind, not even knowing or having no vision, no clue of where to go. Because that faith, that religious faith they have, only works inside of the church. And we don't live inside the church. We do not dwell inside the church, am I right? So then our battles are where? They are outside of the church. At work, at home, in the street. Isn't it so? So then, when you are outside, you cannot count with that emotional faith that you sing inside of the church or that you present in the church. You can't. You can't lean on that faith. Because the faith that pleases God is that faith of sacrifice, is that faith that is dealt with action and goes against our will, that goes against our heart. Jesus said it when He says, if anyone loves father, mother more than me is not worthy of me. If anyone loves son, daughter more than I, they are not worthy of me. Whoever loves their life will lose it. And who loses their life for my sake, they will find it. So, faith that pleases God is completely turned to sacrifice, sacrifices of the heart, sacrifices of relatives, sacrifices even of your personal life. And this kind of faith, you will not find it anywhere. It is a stone that you only find when you truly search with all your strength, when you truly dig down. So many people who are listening to me right now, they have been dealing with this religious faith. Because when you praise God, of course you feel good, right? We do feel good whenever we are glorifying God. But that faith that makes us to glorify God not always will solve the problems on the outside. Because when the tribulation comes, when the storm comes, yes, that's when you get sad. That's when you abandon the church. That's when you want to abandon everybody. Simply because you were in God's presence for so long, for so many years, and now, when a problem comes, your faith can't solve it. Simply because there are two kinds of faith. There are two kinds of faith. The religious faith, which is with emotion, which is emotional, and the faith which is intelligent. The faith that rationalizes, the faith that thinks through, the supernatural faith, which is the faith that the Holy Spirit gives us. And this kind of faith, the intelligent faith, whether at home, whether in the church, whether in the street, whatever is the place, the person is in faith. They live in faith. They live faith in faith, sacrificing and sacrificing because of faith. Faith is like the apostle says, faith without works, faith without actions is dead. And it's not the action of worship. He did not give us faith. He doesn't give the spirit of faith for us to only worship and worship. That is easy to do. And we praise God whenever there is an environment of worship. But when you are dealing with problems, when you have to deal with your flesh and deny the sins, when you deny temptation, now then, there is no emotion right there. There is no feelings there. That is where the person needs to use the faith that makes the difference. And it's the faith that is to obey, the faith of obedience to God's word. So, God, He gives us, through His Spirit, through the Spirit of faith, He gives us that so that we can glorify Him inside of the church, as well at home, or in the street, wherever we go. And we are the temple of the Holy Spirit. So, when He dwells in us, so then, we are always glorifying Him, not only with words, but also with our lives, with the action of our lives, and the actions of sacrificing, of our will, in order to do the will of our Father. That is why He also says, He concludes by saying, just as the body without the Spirit is dead, so faith without works is dead also. So, if faith is dead, they are also spiritually dead. As we have been speaking and saying, that faith is what makes us to stand. Faith is what makes us to stand. And the faith with actions. Faith with courage. Faith to deny this world completely and to just seek the kingdom of the Lord Jesus. So what is your faith, my dear listener? Maybe you are that kind of person that had faith only to conquer the blessings. But when the problems or the losses came, you abandoned faith. Perhaps you are that kind of person, like the 9 lepers. 10 of them were healed. 10 lepers, they were healed. But only one returned. Only one remained in faith. And the other 9, they left. Maybe your faith is like that. You have faith to conquer the blessings. And once you don't conquer any blessings, you begin to say, God is no longer with me. God is no longer with me. And how many tribulations we have endured just to learn to trust with faith, with the practical faith, to believe in the promises of God, that His word does not return empty. The word that comes from His mouth will not return empty. That's what He says. So when your faith is based and sustained upon the word of God and not on feelings, so then the person knows that in the moment of difficulty, the moment of the storm, God is with them and that God will set them free. Paul, he also spoke about that when he was there in Asia. And he was, let's say he was so afflicted by the tribulations in his time that he came to the point to be desperate of life, of living, because he was almost getting desperate. But the word of God, God Himself, was not far from him and kept him and remained, sustained him. So, my dear listener, God, He allows us to go through, He allows us to be thrown into the lion's den of life. But He does not allow the lions to destroy us and kill us. No. But we are taken and put inside of the lion's den. But He keeps us from the lions. So the tribulations of life is like that. When you have an intelligent faith, you have the conscience that all the battles you go through, you are going to pass and overcome them. It's like the seasons. Sometimes the seasons or the weather is raining, sometimes it's sunny. We have all the seasons of the year, so there is the time to plant, and there is the time also to reap. There are moments that we need, or that we laugh, and that we are joyful, and there are moments that we are sad, and there are moments that we become angry. There are moments that we even become furious in life. But those that remain in faith and live by faith with the intelligence based on the Word of God, they have no problems. They overcome all the problems. They overcome bad days. They overcome bad days and finally enjoy the good days in life. And we live faith in faith. Sacrifice to sacrifices. So do not, you who are a person of faith, I tell you, you who have been conquering this and conquering that, you have been conquering all over. But please do not forget, there will come a time where you're going to stop no longer conquering. And when you stop conquering, it's not because you did not conquer that now you're going to be angry, sad. No. Because the same God that once made you to conquer all things, He is still with you. And His word is still valid in your life. The tribulations will come and difficulty will come. But we must remain in faith because His word cannot return empty. He will not abandon us in the moment of tribulation. Jesus did not abandon the disciples on the side when the storm came. He was there. So, dear listener, if Jesus is in your boat, you can be certain. The storm may come. May whatever storm come, nothing will happen to you. Because you will pass through those moments. You may get wet because of the storm. It's natural. but you're not going to suffer. You're not going to lose not even one hair of your head, because the true faith is ready to enjoy the days in life as well as to face the most terrible days of life, the days that no one wants to go through, but all of us will have to deal with it. Jesus, he received the baptism with the Holy Spirit. And what did the Holy Spirit do? The first action of the Holy Spirit in Jesus' life took him to the desert. Jesus was taken to the desert immediately. Immediately, so that he could be tested, tempted. And because he remained in faith and lived by faith, he overcame the devil only using the word of God. Man shall not live by bread alone. Man shall not live by victories only. Man shall not only deal with problems, but will live by every word of God.
Standing in your ruins feels a lot like the end. So used to losing, you're afraid to try again. Right now all you see are ashes where there was a flame. Truth is that you're not forgotten, 'cause grace knows your name. God's not done with you. Even with your broken heart and your wounds and your scars, God's not done with you. Even when you're lost and it's hard and you're falling apart, God's not done with you. It's not over, it's only begun. So don't hide, don't run, 'cause God's not done with you. There's a light you don't notice until you're standing in the dark. And there's a strength that's growing inside your shattered heart. God's not done with you. Even with your broken heart and your wounds and your scars, God's not done with you. Even when you're lost and it's hard and you're falling apart, it's not over, it's only begun. So don't hide, don't run, 'cause God's not done with you. You. He's got a plan, this is part of it. He's gonna finish what he started. He's got a plan, this is part of it. He's gonna finish what he started. God's not done writing your story. No, he's not done. God's not done with you.
God's not done with you.
Even with your broken heart and your wounds and your scars,
God's not done with you.
He's not done.
Even
with
you, lost and it's hard and you're falling apart,
God's not done with you. It's not. He's not done, God's not done with you.